Taekwondo and Okinawan style, actually, over the years. My favorite part was I have a good friend, Chuck. Chuck has been in the Navy for 26 years. Chuck is EOD, Explosive Ordnance Disposal, and several tours in the Middle East and other places in the world. He said he finally took a desk job at 46. But I still find a reason to get out. But Chuck and I train in different styles. Chuck's training with SEALs. He's gone on missions with Green Beret and the whole nine yards. And so he's talking about the problem and all that kind of stuff and all that kind of stuff. And the reason I bring all this up is when I started Radix, the staff of apostolate 22 years ago based out of Lincoln, Nebraska, the idea behind Radix, the name, Latin, meaning root, where we get the English word radical, which it really has nothing to do with surfing or being Republican, but radical means to go to the heart or to the root of something. And the idea behind Radix when we began it was to get out and talk about the faith, into the heart and the root of it. And that's really what the speakers today, what these gentlemen talk about, and what I mentioned last night, is that we look at it back to the heart. I look at Al's talk in particular about really comparing us to the early church, and you look at it and think, wow, where are we gone? Where are we at? Are we really engaged in this battle for souls that the church exists for? For the battle of souls. Right? You know, and I love Tim talking about, you've got to be those Catholics on the bicycle coming down the road, here they come. Why? Because they're not in this position, they're in this position. You know, what we didn't do with Jesse Paul, I thought everybody was saying this when he said, the serenity is surrounding us, that simplifies our problem. It was right in that context of being in front of Joseph, you know. But really, that's the attitude we need to have as Catholics. And so when I started Radix, the idea was to travel and talk about the basics of the faith, that, as I mentioned last night, the Ten Commandments, the Rosary, and so forth. Year and a half ago, I was walking to the office at home, and my son is 20, he works for me, and my daughter works for me as well, and I walked to the office and I said, son, we need something to wake up us at. Really wake us up, something that's more terminology driven that we understand and relate to. Because a lot of guys will say, well, the Catholic faith, I don't quite get it. I learned it from my grandma. In fact, a friend of mine, David Cuvio, wrote a book called Real Men Pray the Rosary. He has a ministry by the same name. He's down in McAllen. And Real Men Pray the Rosary has over 75,000 likes on Facebook. It's a great, great group, great book. And David says in the book, he's in his 50s, he said, I only thought the rosary was for old ladies at funerals. So that's the only time you ever heard it, saw it. Okay, that's our problem. So I said to my son, we need something to wake us up. We need to be prepared for the fight. We need to be ready for the battle. And I think my son said, we need to be battle ready. And I said, I like it. So I started to write emails 4 or 5 days a week to anybody who signed up. And I started a little website, battlereadystrong.com. And the emails go out about once a week now, maybe twice a week, depending on my schedule and my time. And they're just simple reminders. Now, we all know we're inundated with a ton of emails, so I'm not here to push that. But that's how it began. The Battle Ready Initiative was to use terminology that we men understand, that relates to what's really in the heart of a man, that the church has been teaching from the beginning. From the beginning. All right, gentlemen? And I mentioned this last night, but I got this t-shirt, again, shameless commercial, I still sell these, and everyone over there, right next to these guys' stuff. Their stuff's better than mine. Actually, Tim and I are working on a deal. You buy one of my t-shirts, you get one of his CDs free.
He didn't know that, but I
and Doug's going to pay for it.
I'm going to pay, wait a minute. Battle Ready, established 33 AD, chains broken, death conquered. When our Lord gave us life on the cross, when he gave us the sacrament of confession, as Father Casey quoted the Gospel of John, he breathed on us to receive the Holy Spirit, he said, you're going to forgive it, he said, you hold that all down. He made us battle ready. He gave us all we needed. He gave us the priesthood. He gave us the papacy. He gave us all the stuff that Al was talking about in the early centuries of the church. He gave us all that we have to fight the spiritual fight, to engage in that spiritual combat, and come out victorious. So gentlemen, when we started this Valerie initiative, the idea was emails. Very quickly, we had 30, 40 people sign up in the first week, and now we're at like 3,500. And I don't push it. I have a clipboard back there at a table in the poster area. You want to put your email on there, we'll add you to it. Once, twice a week, you're going to get an email that says Valerie in caps. And then there's a little quote, a little challenge, a little something for the saints, maybe it's in my own thoughts here, you know. And quote this from that little video clip, whatever it may be. But the point is, even if you delete it, you'll see it in your inbox, battle ready. And the question is, really, to challenge Jesus, are we striving to be ready for the spiritual fight? But what does that mean? It means to be in this position, which is what you guys have been talking about all day. It means to be in this position, not like this, not just ducking and moving and weaving, but out there coming at it. And what's the position stand for? Look, when you're in this position, anybody in a fight stands, so you got a good base, right? You stand like this in a conflict, you're going to get hit, you're going to fall into pieces every time. So you got to get that base, right? Go 820, 8% in the back, 29 in the front. You got to be able to move and absorb and take shots, right? All right? This is like standing on the Word of God and the teachings of the faith. Spiritually, guys, we're going to get knocked on ourselves over and over. As we get in first experience with you today, unless we know what our faith is about. So we engage by having the base that we can stand on spiritually, the wisdom, the knowledge, the teaching of our church. And you got to protect the eyes, the throat, the heart, right? So you got to get your arms up. What's this? This is like prayer and sacraments. You got to keep the prayer and sacraments up at all times. They protect the eyesight because the devil wants the blindness. They protect the throat because the devil wants to choke us out. And they protect the heart because the devil wants to get in there and destroy it. So prayer and sacraments, Word of God, teachings of the faith, and lean in and be ready to move, gentlemen. Be ready to move. That's all about, right? Spiritually prepare for that fight. And this isn't a game and it's not a joke. And I can tell you how many times I've heard this put very clearly. And it's a quote on this little card right here. You only fight the way you train. You only fight the way you train. Right? Those of you that are military or martial arts, law enforcement, you know what that means. You only move into a conflict. You're going to panic and flip out if you've never been trained to handle the conflict in any way, shape, or form. Spiritually, when the devil comes at us, he's throwing all these horrible things at us, all these darts are flying at us, these evil attacks. How do we respond? A lot of times we throw our arms and run. We don't stand in the midst and say, my family's under attack. I'm not going anywhere. Because I know what to go to. My recourse, my rosary, holy water. Mentioned that last time about blessing the home with holy water. Bring holy water to your home every day of your life. That rosary, every day of your life, Father, see, chaplain, regularly. Keep that in your hearts. Sacred scripture should be read, should be devoured, should be consumed. Ignorance of scripture is ignorance of Christ. Oh, man, how we prepare for a spiritual fight if we're ignorant of Christ by being ignorant of scripture. You only fight the way you train, gentlemen. Every single day is training day for us. Because every single day is battle day, because we're always in the midst of the battle. Now, this is a great quote from Psalm 144, verse 1. Blessed be the Lord, my strength, who trains my hands for battle and my fingers for war. Don't ever think that our faith is some pansy, wimpy sort of thing. Are you kidding? We have the toughest, greatest teaching on the planet to make us the greatest, most powerful warriors ever. And I'm close with this thought, gentlemen. The day's going to come when we will die. I said last night, I quote that priest from that Calgary Men's Conference a month ago. He said, you know, don't discern your whole life when you're going to get engaged with God, when you're going to do the right thing. He says, you know, you're going to die in your grave, so it's going to save your life. You know, Tom, still discerning what to do. It's a bad way to go out. Right? Take the advice from Al, Tim, Father Casey, you know, and learn the faith now. Know the Word of God. Know the teachings of the faith. Get the prayer and the sacraments going if you're ready to go, man, because it's all around us. And that priest said this to him in Calgary. He said, your life is short and your death may be sudden. Right? And we've all been given opportunities. We all have battles. We're all fighting battles. What's yours? What is the battle that you fight? We all have something. This morning, I know Tim was gracious enough to inspire all these y'all some prayer for me. What happened? 4 years ago, I'll give you this in a nutshell. 4 years ago, I was diagnosed with ulcerative colitis. I had a digestive tract disease. It's similar to Crohn's disease in some ways, right? So my days are up and down. I can't even tell you from day to day what I eat, what I don't eat. Sometimes I can't eat through most of the day because if I eat some today, some of my whole life is going to be whacked out. There's multiple problems I won't go into the details on. But I will tell you this, for the first couple of years, I complained about it to God. What would I travel for a living and speak? How am I supposed to handle this when I got fast reports today? We're going to get on an airplane and fly across the country. I don't get this. And then I realized that I felt like God was saying, but I've given you something to fight with. How did Jesus save the world? Die. Carried across the top of Calvary and suffered brutal death for our salvation. And as John Paul II should be saying, what did he say? He said in one of his meditations that when Jesus allowed Simon the Cyrenian to step into the streets to help carry the cross, Simon didn't know it, but Jesus was allowing Simon to assist in the salvation of the world. Incredible. So with your suffering in mind, which we look at only as a negative, yeah, it doesn't feel good. No, don't look for it. It'll come, right? But when we We all got something. We all have a battle. We all got suffering. We all got a thorn in the side. St. Paul, right? We all have something. Use it. Engage in that fight with the cross in front of your hand right there. All right? Archbishop Olchin said this, the greatest problem in our world is not all suffering. The greatest problem in our world is all the wasted suffering. Wasted. Don't waste it. I have colitis. The doctor said I have it the rest of my life. I'm fine. My wife, God bless her, has done amazing things. I lost 50 pounds the first 8 months when I had it. Right? 50 pounds, man. People emailing, you know, like the rock you did. Doug said he's dying. What's going on? My response, we all are. So I have time. Gentlemen, and then I started to say, Lord, you give this to me. You know what I'm going to do with it every day? Lord, take this sickness, take whatever it is. My wife and my children, I pray for the salvation. I pray for the holiness. I pray for the protection of people and harm. Lord, please take this. Even when I'm complaining. So, gentlemen, I will leave you with this. If and when you have those low moments in your life, when you are down, when you just want to curl up and let the earth just absorb you, you want to melt into the ground because you're so discouraged, you're so down, cross the weight of everything, so heavy. Those are the moments you really find out what kind of men we are. Those are the moments we really understand that we're in the middle of a battle. We're being tested right there. Those are the moments where like our Lord in the garden. We're always standing there in the middle. And he's trying to go to sleep over here. And Jesus is over here in a huddled, bloody, sweaty mass. In his agony. And we're right in the middle. We can't even go near him, it feels like, because even the atmosphere around Jesus, as some of the saints would say, when he moved into his agony, it was if darkened figures of hell began to dance all around him. So imagine even walking near him when he's sobbing and feeling that agony. And yet we're called to. Jesus says, come to me. So what did he say to his disciples before he fell into his agony? He looked at them and he didn't say, go solve the world's problems. He didn't say, go out by the thesis. He didn't say, go out, build bridges and cure diseases. He said this, stay with me. When you're in your agony, gentlemen, lowest point of your life, and you feel like you're just beat to a pulp, it's at those moments sometimes we are really closest to Christ and we are engaged in that battle. Turn the heart, like I talked about last time, right? Turn that heart towards God, give it to him, and say, Lord, I don't understand this, I don't know how you do this, but I give you my suffering as a weapon for the spiritual fight, and be valid. And only fight the way we train. Train with our Lord. Train with our Lord. Let it be your master. God bless you, gentlemen. Thank you so much.